are five ways to find RC plane CG. Imagine there's a line that divides the wing chord or the width of the wing into half the chord, and then on the front half portion divide it again. The CG is on that line.
This video is sponsored by Skillshare.
Hello guys, in this episode I'm going to talk about CG. The CG is center of gravity. Is the most important thing for RC model flight, because without setting up the CG correctly, your plane will have a bigger chance to crash on the first flight. When aircraft is flying, it's hanging on its wing or served on top of the wing, so the CG is usually located on the wing, but not always. For traditional configuration like plane with wing and stabilizers, the CG is always on the wing. Except the plane with canard, the CG may be located off the wing. CG is a center where the plane balances when flying, not on the ground, but when it flies. CG in aviation actually quite complicated, but for model aircraft it's quite simple. There are 5 ways to find RC plane CG. I compiled them from the easiest to the hardest.
Number 1.
It's very simple. Look at this. This is Sky Arrow's wing. Imagine there's a line that divides the wing chord or the width of the wing into half the chord. And then on the front half portion, divide it again. The CG is on that line. It also can be used for the wing that has relatively same chord length from the root to the wingtip, like this Cessna Skymaster's wing. But this method can be used for the tapered wing or delta wing, like on the jets. So how to find the CG of this type of wings? It's on the next one.
Number 2.
I'm going to show you how to find the CG with these sticks and threads. In this case, I use an elastic thread, so it will always straight because it always has tension. I will use this wing T45 Gosok as an example. The logic is still the same from the first method, which is the CG is 25% of the wing chord measured from the front. But for the taper wing like this, which chord we need to measure? To be able to measure, we have to find the average chord, or MAC, or MAC. MAC is mean aerodynamic chord, or the average width of the wing.
First, measure the wing tip and leave a mark on the stick. We have to simplify the wing like this. So better to find the CG when the wing haven't been installed to the fuselage. And then measure the wing root. Now we have both wing root and wing tip measurement on the stick. We need to copy the measurement to the other stick. Put the stick with the wing tip length on the front like this. And then put the other stick with the wing root length to the rear like this. And then connect both ends with elastic thread. Continue with connecting the middle of the wing root with the middle of the wing tip. On the intersection point, draw a line parallel to the wing root. That's the MAC. Remember, CG is 20% of MAC. Before going to number 3, I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community with a lot of topics and interesting classes. You can learn new skill here. Like this class, Blender 2.8 Game Vehicle Creation by Darren Lyle. This class has 124 lessons for you to learn and try.
That we can use if you like. There are higher resolution images that you can pay for, of course. Alright, let's work on the fender now. If I tumble around here, I think what we can do is tab into edit mode.
The lessons have step-by-step instructions that easy to follow. Skillshare is designed for learning and there is no ads. Skillshare now offers 1 month free trial. The first 1,000 people that click the link on the description will get 1 month free trial. To get it, just click the link on this video descriptions and you can start your creativity today. Number 3. The logic is still the same from method number 2, but you need to draw the wing on paper, in smaller scale. First, we need to measure the wing root, wingspan, distance of the leading edge swept, and the wing tip. Draw the wing in half scale, and length of the wing root here to the back. Put the wing tip length on the front of the root here. Make a line connecting both ends like this. And then make a center line of the wing. On the intersection point, we got the MAC. And the CG is here, 25% of MAC. Because the drawing is in half the scale of the real model, so the CG is on 6.4 cm times 2 equal 12.8 cm from the leading edge. We can also draw lines on photo like this using MS Paint.
Number 4. These are two websites that I usually use for finding the CG. eCalc and Flying Wing CG Calculator. eCalc site needs more parameters to be input, because it also using the stabilizer as parameters that affect the calculation of the CG. While on Flying Wing CG Calculator, it has less parameters that need to be input. I prefer Flying Wing CG Calculator because it's simpler, so it will be less chance of errors. I have a couple near crash incidents because I'm not careful enough when inserting lots of measurement for the calculation on eCalc, and then resulting miscalculation of the CG. Flying Wing CG Calculator is for Flying Wing CG, but it also can be used for traditional plane. If your plane needs special calculation, you can use eCalc or try both and compare them. How to use Flying Wing CG Calculator? First, we need to simplify the wing like this. We just need half of the wing. Insert the wingspan in any unit, which is 47.5 times 2 is 95 cm. Now insert root chord, which is 51.8 cm. And then insert the wing tip or tip chord, which is 12.4 cm. And for the last, insert sweep, which is the distance of the wing tip from the root chord. You can see the graphic above the form for guidance. That's the CG with 20% chord. You can also change it to 25% chord, and then click update to update the graphic. Number 5. The last method can be considered the hardest because it needs more effort to build a simple model using foam like this. But if you are enjoying building it, so it can also consider the easiest. Just toss the plane until it have a good flying characteristic by adjusting ballast on the nose. When you got the best setup, balance the plane on its wing until the plane is balanced like this. And the CG is on the end of its struts here. Mark it with pen, scale it up again on the bigger model. The smaller model is 1/10 of the bigger model. The CG in the smaller model is 3.2 cm from the trailing edge. So the CG for the bigger model is 32 cm from the trailing edge. Okay guys, there are 5 ways to find your RC plane CG. One more tip, CG actually has tolerance, not absolute. You can use 30% to 20% of max. The bigger the percent, the farther the CG distance to the back. More to the back means less stability, but still on the safe envelope. On contrast, more to the front means more stability. That's why we say better to fly a nose heavy plane than a tail heavy plane. So I suggest for the first flight, use CG on 25% to 20% of max. I'm still working on the ADF F-16 for the next video. Thanks for watching, see you on the next video.
Mana sih dia?